Sex education
is that one change all the day?
Thursday from 7 to 9 p.m. and Fridays from 9 p.m. to midnight with Dr. Raj Ramnaman, the guru of sex in the Caribbean.
A lot of times we think that sex is totally below the waist. It is not below the waist. It starts in the brain. The largest sex organ that you possess is your brain.
Tune in for discussion on all sexual matters. Sexplosion on Power 102, empowering you.
Well, thank you for staying here with us on Power 102.1 FM, and we do welcome you to Trinidad and Tobago, number one nighttime program when it comes to sex education, Sexplosion on Power 102 FM with the guru of sex education, Dr. Raj Ramnaman of Total Image and the Adult Therapy Center located in St. Augustine, where he do treats all sexual dysfunctions in both male and female. And a very special good evening to you, my big brother. How are you today?
Pleasant good evening to you. I'm fine. Mm-hmm. There's a good evening to all the viewers, all the listeners, those of you on the World Wide Web.
Yeah, yes, the World Wide Web. It's a beautiful place to be.
Well, at least they were hearing me live. My apologies for those who weren't hearing me. Yeah. Again, let's start all over. Mm-hmm. Pleasant good evening to everyone. For those of you on radio, or for us, those of you on the World Wide Web, on our app, on social media, good evening. We're here to talk about sex,
yes, and
everything to do with sex, yes. And it's a Friday evening. But we have so many things to deal with. First of all, last night's program was a bumper program, and I know a lot of you have a lot of comments about it. And I did have calls, about 10 calls, dealing with the issue of a person having their child in their bedroom and the dangers of that and the things that happens in the bedroom. And I'll address one or two things about that. Another issue was the young man we had on the program, Prashant,
yeah,
where we discuss diabetes and the treatment of diabetes and what we'll be doing at the Adult Therapy Center in St. Augustine come Wednesday. A lot of persons have called and made the appointment for this Wednesday. Some persons have asked if it is an ongoing thing, but of course you got to start somewhere.
Yes.
And if you start with this Wednesday and there are enough persons to come to the clinic on Wednesday, of course, then you go on to the next Wednesday. So for now, this Wednesday coming,
yeah,
I think it's the 13th, day before Valentine's Day, right?
Right, yeah.
Well, I know you're celebrating Valentine's Day in a big way, right?
Mm-hmm.
I heard that.
I'm looking, is that right?
I heard that. That's what I heard.
I'm looking forward to it, but I don't know what to expect. You know, you can always expect the unexpected.
Well, you know why I don't celebrate Valentine's Day anymore? Mm-hmm. About 20 years ago, my wife and I went to this restaurant,
yeah,
made reservations, everything, ended up at the restaurant on time. We were shuttled in, put in a corner to sit down,
yeah,
nice small table, food quick, like they were just dealing with you as fast as possible, drop the dessert and they were gone. You had to leave there in about half an hour.
Oh yes, they try to hustle.
That's what Valentine's, yeah, is all about,
yeah,
commercialism.
Sure.
So
yeah,
we got rid of that, we never celebrated it again outside. Of course, for those of you who are in love and you want to do it, fine,
yeah,
go ahead.
That's why
no big deal.
It's always good to celebrate.
Junior will take you out, for
it's
sure.
Always, it's always good to celebrate Valentine's with a fast food. Doesn't matter which
fast
particular
food
one. Yeah.
Why?
Because
No, you don't
have to wait.
Okay, you don't have to wait.
No.
And if you go to the restaurant, you get it faster. But when you go to the restaurant, you get it faster because they want to get rid of you.
Yeah, you
get want to fill the tables as much as they can.
You will get it faster, but you cannot have a conversation after.
Oh, no, you can't have no conversation.
No.
The minute you go to say, boo, that's it. And we need your table, sir. Yeah.
So the best thing to do is to get something quick the night before, and the following night, then you celebrate. So you celebrate Valentine's
Day. But people go,
Day,
people go for the because it's Valentine's Day and the specials that they have and whatnot, they go for that. But of course, you know, Valentine's Day is every day for me because I celebrate it every single day.
And I don't like specials.
I know you have a double meaning to that. I'm trying to figure it out. But
in the meantime, they're going to give you a special for Valentine's
Day. A pleasant good evening to a few people here. Let's go say hello to them. Indira, Ina, Sandy, Kavita, Derek, my good friend from high school, Sangri Randy Boy, Hanif, Nixon, Sabrina, my good friend, Dr. Tiwari, Natalie, Sharina, Rihad, Jojo, Bola, Sunita, Timmy, Sachin, my nephew, Randy, Rennie, Annalisa, good evening to you all. I know we have some persons on Instagram, Anna, and the rest. I have to say special, special good evening to someone here. Should I? Yes, you should. Yes. She knows who she is. Rochella.
Rochella?
Yeah. New name, right? You got a shock. I know that. I'm saying a special evening. Good evening to
Well, before we go further and we start the...
Where I want to start yet? I want to start here because some bumper things to talk about, so you go ahead.
So we're going to take a break and we would be right back with you. Stay tuned.
I catch you without name,
Semis, Calypso Fiesta.
Fiesta National Junior Calypso Monarch Final. It's a terrific Thursday. Celebrating the Masters. Playing now on Power 102.
I knew I had to be on stage. I felt this is a place.
Celebrating the Masters. Ticket giveaways for Army Fett and more. Interesting historical features like Origins of the Mass, Folktales, Fables, and Legends. Calypso Stories, Characters of Carnival. And to keep you updated and in the know, our Carnival Calendar 2019, along with so much more.
What I don't understand is that the advertising thing said I'd gone already.
You can't do that. I wouldn't advertise it.
No, I would not do it. The advertising is okay in square.
Nah, etc. That must have been for the earlier
things. One called Masters Tony. I am pretty sure that gone. But I have no way of listening to it before playing it.
Well, if after you listen to it.
No, I have no way of listening.
Yeah, I mean, if after you realize that, don't do that. You don't have control over it.
But remember to continue to be safe for yourself and those around you, your friends, family members, and fellow carnival lovers. Listen to our daily fat safety tips and get more information on our website and social media outlets. Let's all remain vigilant and most of all, safe. This carnival season.
Think twice.
Powered by Vancott,
the Vehicle Management Corporation of Trinidad and Tobago.
Power 102
and Bull 94 is sponsored by
Needham Massey Credit Union
in an association with Computers and Controls.
Agricola Credit Union.
Arrive alive in the TTPS.
Think twice. For safer fetting, partying, and carnival season. Think twice.
Well, contender, this is what it's all about, taking sex education to a whole new level, exclusively on Power 102.1 FM, with the guru of sex education, Dr. Raj Ramnanan of Total Image and the Adult Therapy Center, located in St. Augustine. Yeah.
Yeah, so we have so many things to deal with, as I was saying, and of course, one troubling incident that took place, I don't know when it took place, but someone sent me a video on it. Well, not someone, a few persons sent me a video of it because they know I would make mention of it. You know, I'm a big fan of Marshall Montano.
Yes,
big fan.
Yes, huge fan. I know that.
He's also my friend. But he did something that is in very poor taste. Mm-hmm. He actually tried to entertain the crowd with a bhajan. First of all, he didn't sing the right words. Secondly, it's no place to do that. You don't do something like that in a crowd that is fetid. Alcohol and whatnot, that is something that is sacred, that has to be done in an environment where there is devotion taking place. A fet is not devotion. You might be devoted to other things, but it's not devotion. So, Marshall, I think you need to apologize for that and don't make that mistake again. Mm-hmm. I really think that it's in poor taste because any Indian artist would know never go on a stage and do something like that.
You don't
try to move a crowd with a bhajan. You don't.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely not. The second one that he sang was okay, but the bhajan, Jai Ganesha, no, not at all. So let's put that to rest because he is a fantastic entertainer. He's somebody I really admire, and I think it was in poor taste. Maybe he got swayed by the crowd or something made him do it, but the crowd wasn't swayed by it. I could tell you that.
Yeah.
Because I'm sure if there was any Hindu in that crowd, they would have been offended.
Well, of course, they would have been offended what was taking place at that particular time. So
let's not beat it, but I would really like us to put that to rest. Not because it's Marshall, but because, of course, it's the season and all these things does happen and we need to move on.
Well, there's a possibility he might have not been aware of the...
He's very aware.
He's aware.
He's a spiritual person. He's very aware. Mm-hmm. He's very aware. That's what I said, that in that moment of weakness, that is what happened. But he's a very spiritual person, so he's supposed to know.
Okay.
And he's
okay.
Yeah, it's not a mockery, I'll tell you, it's not a mockery.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't done in a mocking way. He genuinely thought he was doing something good. But it's not the thing that you do. Time and place for everything. In life, there's time and place for everything.
Well, of course, yes.
You know? Mm-hmm. Even when I'm asked to do lectures, like in churches and temples and whatnot, I know how to tone down my lectures. I know what I have to. I could say and what I cannot say.
Mm-hmm.
I will change the way I approach subjects.
Yeah.
And even when persons asking questions, you can hear them toning down the way they ask questions. If it's in a public forum, a civic center or something like that, that's okay. It's different. Even in a school, you have to change up the way you make a presentation.
Well, of course.
Especially if it is the, when I used to, in those days when I used to do primary schools and high schools and whatnot. I would tune it to that. But of course, when you're dealing with adults, it's a different thing. So you've got to know your time and place for everything.
Yeah.
Not because I'm a sexologist and I talk about sex, I'll talk about sex openly in an environment where it's one of devotion.
Mm-hmm.
You know, there are certain things to be said and there are certain things that you don't say. So, getting back to the program, some of the things that stood out to me were the phone calls that I got. Let's take that call.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Hi, hello, and welcome to Sexplosion. Good evening.
You want to be an angel, but you're kind of early.
Yeah, very, very early, as a matter of fact.
Yes, so one of the things that stood out to me with the program yesterday was talking about this issue of having your child in your bedroom, not considering your spouse to be a lover, looking at your spouse as a parent, the parent of the child now, and losing that interest in your relationship or the sexual part of your relationship. I had one young lady call me and tell me, you know, this is something that is happening. The child has been in the bedroom for the longest while. There's a crib in the bedroom. The child don't sleep in the bed with them, but there's a crib in the bedroom. And she have caught the child looking at them when they have having sex. And she feels very uncomfortable. Now, the child is not going to figure out that if they're having sex.
No.
But they're seeing action and they're seeing movement and they're hearing sounds. So they'll be attracted to that. And how could you perform 100% knowing that a child is looking at you? You're not going to feel comfortable because it's your child. You shouldn't be doing it in front of a child anyway. So there are things that you got to take into consideration. Again, time and place.
Yes,
time and place. So if something like that is happening and you find yourself in a situation where that child is in the bedroom, you got to know what you're doing. Put a curtain so it separates. Sometimes I know people are faced with challenges. Sometimes they have a one-bedroom apartment. Fine, put a curtain that you could draw. Do something, hang a bed sheet. Do something to alleviate that problem. And also take into consideration that child will have to move out eventually from the room. Because there'll come a time when that child will know what's going on. So you have to be careful about that also.
Yeah, but apart from that, even, you know, you have a crib in a bedroom, you will feel uncomfortable. Even though the child may be sleeping,
you will feel uncomfortable. I can't see you having a child in your bedroom and you'll be amorous with your partner and engage in a sexual situation.
No.
It's not going to be comfortable for you at all. How could you get an erection doing that?
It's
kind of hard.
No, but you know there are some fellas over there.
Yeah, I know, but still the woman has some saying that
because
also.
Because they are more emotional.
Well, not emotional, but they're mother.
Mm-hmm.
So, but you know, it's a protection. Mothers protect, you know. A mother will give her life for a child, you know, remember that?
Oh, yes, they will.
Right?
Yes.
That's why, King Solomon, when he said to divide the child in two, the mother said, no, give the child away.
Mm-hmm.
So that's when he knew that that was the mother.
Mm-hmm.
And even in the Gita, when you talk about Lord Krishna and his brothers being killed, the baby's being killed before he was born.
Yeah.
And when he was born, the mother made sure somebody took that child out of the prison and passed through the biggest flood, walk with that child out of the jail to take care of that child.
Mm-hmm.
The mother gave up that because she knew the child would be killed.
Mm-hmm.
So all these things in every single religion, you have something like that. You have that being depicted, the role of the mother and how important it is for the mother to do the right things. And the mother instinctively know what to do. You know? They know the right things to do.
Well, of course, yeah.
It's instinctive. So we have to look at that. You know, one lady was telling me about her partner, her husband. They marry, they have a child. If the husband insists on sleeping with the child, young man, he's preteen, and if he's not sleeping in the child's bedroom, the child is sleeping in a bed with him. The mother has moved out of the room. She wants sex because she's a sexual, sensual person. She's in her prime of her life. He cannot satisfy her because he don't want to do anything with her for whatever reason, medical reason or other reasons. He have an issue with having intercourse with her. So she got some toys. Now he's telling her either the toys go or she goes.
Uh-huh.
But he's telling her in the other breath that she could find a lover to satisfy her. Now she's of the opinion that it all has to do with church. The church frowns upon her using a toy. But I ask a simple question. The church do frown upon infidelity?
Yeah.
Why are you telling you to get a lover? You could get a lover, have a lover to make love to you and satisfy you, but you can't have a toy.
Well,
she don't want her husband. She made it very clear. I do not want to step outside of the marriage. She has been to a number of so-called sexologists and therapists and whatever. And when they told her, I said, which sexologist will tell you that? I said, that person is not a trained sexologist or therapist. The things that you're telling me that they tell you is outside the realm of sexology.
Yes, but when you're thinking in terms of your her options, I would figure a toy would be much better than having an outside person.
Well, I would think so also. I mean, that is the logical thing to do. Mm-hmm. And there are so many variations with toys and other things that you can use to get satisfaction. And a woman needs that satisfaction, so why not?
Yeah.
If you could agree to your wife having a partner, a honor man, why can't you agree to a toy?
Yeah.
The logic doesn't add up. And something is wrong there, so she has a lot of issues with dealing with her husband, and I think she's getting advice from the wrong people. I'll tell you something, nobody in a church is a sexologist. Eh? Mm-hmm. There'll be a conflict. There'll be a total conflict. Anybody who tells me that they belong to a church, they're a pastor and whatnot, and they're a sexologist,
yeah,
you're fooling yourself. That's or you're fooling your congregation.
That's a no-go.
You can be a counselor, but you can't be a sex therapist or a sexologist. No way. Mm-hmm. Absolutely no way. There'll be too much conflict for you to be that. Hmm. So that's something you have to take into consideration and something you have to look at. We have some questions here that were sent out to me because I did send out a broadcast and I asked, could you please send me some questions? Let's deal with them because this is the program where you deal with these questions and it's very important. You know, they say the best place to start is at the beginning. Eh?
Right.
But if you ever see my phone, the beginning of my phone is... FK, if you're listening, and thank you for being a part of the program. Another initial you don't know about. I see WP is on and Izzy is on.
Oh, well, I know those.
You know those?
Yeah.
Right, I'm sure you know those. So, any type of question. Because I want to have sex. I want to have sex if I have herpes. I've been alone since but I don't want it to remain that way. So how do I tell someone I'm interested in having sex or a relationship with and I have this situation? Well, of course, there is a treatment for herpes. We do the treatment at the Adult Therapy Center. Actually, we have the cure. It's obsidian. It's something that was invented many years ago. The scientist was here in Trinidad on my program on Synergy, Sexplosion on Synergy. And we spoke about it ad nauseum.
Yeah.
I have had a lot of clients who have used the product and they're very successful with it. You could have herpes and still have sex, you know.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, you got to know your timing and you just take the guidance from your virologist or from your doctor and let your partner know and you can have safe sex.
Yes, but in a position like that, your partner would feel uncomfortable to a certain extent.
Well, if the partner understand mm-hmm. herpes is not a death sentence, you know. Mm-hmm. It's not. We all have herpes one, you know, every one of us.
Uh-huh.
Cold sores. We get cold sores, whether we have fever or we, what we call juta in Hindi.
Okay.
There's no other equivalent word for it in English, juta.
Mm-hmm.
So Indian or a person who have an Indian background will know what juta is. That little button that you just get around the lips and when you take something from somebody and whatnot, they call it juta. If you get that, that is herpes 1. Everyone has that. That virus is in your system. Herpes 2 is also in your system to a smaller extent, about 60% of the population. Herpes 3, most persons have gotten it already. Smallpox, chickenpox, shingles.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's my herpes.
So all those poxes are herpes. So we have it in our system. It's in the air. It's airborne. You can get it airborne. You can get it by touch. I tell my clients who have herpes, it's not a death sentence. You got to know how to manage it. You got to let your partner know. You have to know when you're shedding. Don't have intercourse, oral, digital, or otherwise. Mm. And it's as simple as that. It's not a death sentence. Why can't you have sex? There are persons who have AIDS and they still have sex.
Yeah.
So why can't you have sex with herpes? So it's something that you should tell your partner and you should deal with it from that angle. Somebody asked a question about having sex during your period. Now, for religious reason, for moral reason, you may choose not to. That's fine. There's no danger in having sex during a period. It's going to be messy if the woman is menstruating at the moment of having intercourse. Some guys are turned on by it. Some guys are not. Some women are very turned on by it. Some women, their horniest time is during their period. You got to know what works best for you. You could use a dental dam and have oral sex with someone during their period if you know what you're doing. Everything takes practice. Everything, there's a solution for it. If you don't have dental dam, a simple thing as Saran wrap that you can buy at any grocery, which is much cheaper than a dental dam. You tear a piece off, you put it over the vagina, and you could perform oral sex. You remember long ago we used to put plastic bag over a comb and blow it and make sound?
Yeah.
You remember that?
And lips
you don't
tickle,
hear a long boy.
And your lips used to tickle you.
Well, right. So you do the very thing, to, very same thing to the vagina. You put that Saran wrap over the vagina, you pull it tight, and you blow onto it. But you got to have the rhythm, Dave.
Yes, you got to have rhythm, all right. Yeah. And
so there's so many things that you can do during in a period that you can fully understand, enjoy sex. So why not?
Okay. Well, we're going to stick a pin on that. We're going to take a break, and we're going to come right back. You're listening to Sexplosion on this Friday evening with the guru of sex education, Dr. Raj Ramanan of Total Image and the Adult Therapy Center. We're going to come right back. Stay tuned.
In Focus, Carnival 2K19. This Wednesday, February 13, we're bringing the greatest show on earth, our Carnival, in Focus. We take a look at the artful, the business, the events, the architects, creative masters, and you, the patrons. We trace some of the history of Carnival, where it is today, and where it's heading. Join in on the discussions as we speak with officials, legends, and promoters. Have your say before the show. Send your messages and contributions online and through our app. Car102FM.com. In Focus, Carnival 2K19, this Wednesday, February 13. Tune in to Game Time this Saturday for what promises to be a fiery edition. Trinidad and Tobago Super League and current TTFA board member Keith Lucklaw will be in studio. That's right, he'll address the current lack of transparency in the TTFA home of football, a high-handed approach by the TTFA president, why after 3 years there are no subcommittees appointed, why the slow pace in sorting out financial issues, and much more. So tune in to Game Time just after the midday news on R102.1 FM this Saturday.
Well, just to remind you that you are listening to Sexplosion on Power 102.1 FM, taking sex education to a whole new level with the guru of sex education, Dr. Raj Ramanan of Total Image and the Adult Therapy Center. Well, here's where we give you the opportunity to interact with Dr. Raj live here in studio. He's sitting right beside me. Just simply 2228255. Also at 612-8255. If you do decide that you want to send him a WhatsApp or a text message, you can also do that on his private mobile at 740-1961. You're listening to a program that's informative, educational, and of course entertaining, exclusively on Power 102 FM.
And because the vagina is engorged during that period of time when a woman is on menstruating, there's a lot of sensitivity in that area. Sex is different, the feelings are different. Of course, you have the female condom and you also have the male condom that you can use to have intercourse. Some guys, they don't mind and they continue to have sex normally, bareback. It's no big deal for them to have it with their wives. Some women love it. They just love the sensation and they love the feel of it. One of the questions that was asked of me if I studied Masters and Johnson, and the answer is no, I didn't. In my field of studies, Masters and Johnson was just a reference book, that was it. It's no big deal. Some people believe Masters and Johnson was the ultimate things in sexology. It's not. There are many different books that were written, talking from ancient times to now, that far surpasses Masters and Johnson. Masters and Johnson was considered to be a pioneering effort in the study of sex. A lot of things that were studied were kind of doctored. Some of them, they came to the understanding that it was not reality as it is now. So it was no big deal. So
no big thing.
When I hear people talk about Masters and Johnson, I just smile. It's not sexology. And as a matter of fact, there was no book on sexology prior to the 90s. It was not a topic that was really discussed in that way. So you had to get a reference book and you had to do more things of the psychological nature. Jung and... name slipped me. How could this name slip me? Famous guy. You have to do those studies. You have to understand the mind. You have to understand the mind and the correlation between the mind, body, and soul. You have to understand the correlation between what you're doing and the physical activity with your spouse, with your partner, the person that you're most comfortable with.
Yeah.
So once you are comfortable with that, and that's why I tell persons, Don't ever say no when it comes to a sexual situation, which you have no idea, because you have no idea what you will and will not do. Mm-hmm. Unless you're faced with it. You know, Bob Marley had a saying, you never know what courage is when courage is all you need.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah.
Right? It's the same thing. When you're in a sexual situation, when you're in a sexual situation, you never know what you're going to do until you are faced with that moment. And sexology is not theory. It is not theory. It is 75% practical. Anyone who wants to study sexology and they don't engage in the things that they're studying and they have never participated in some of the things that they're talking about and reading about, you can be a sexologist. Mm-hmm. You'll be a theoretical psychiatrist or something like that, but you can't be a sexologist. No. Sexology is very practical, and persons don't understand that. They don't understand the nature by which and the things that you have to do and the depth that you have to go into. Sexology is so strong, it has to do with the chemistry between two persons. It incorporates that of which of tantra, where you can actually create a sensation in a woman, or a woman creates a sensation in a man that reverberates for a long period of time, even with a split second of meeting or not meeting at all. Mm. You could be chatting with somebody on the telephone.
Yeah.
Skyping or sending WhatsApp messages, and that person will turn you on and you will turn on that person. The person may not admit it, and sometimes you can come out openly and say, this is what is happening to me, and the person will say, well, something like that similarly is happening to me. But that is sexology, and that is the depth at which sexology goes. But it's also therapeutical when you're dealing with issues with individuals who have problems. So there are many aspects of sexology, and don't believe sexology is theoretical, that you read something and you could apply it. If you have never practiced it or never done it, you can't.
Yeah. You got to practice it.
Of course. Rosanna says, hello, Dr. Raj. Good evening. Avia is on. Jai is on. Christina, Deborah, Usha. Sabrina says, yes, so true. Deborah says, so true. I guess that had to do with having oral sex or sexual intercourse during your period. Robin is on. Priya is on. Claudia is on. When you understand these things and you understand the depth at which sexology goes, you could read whatever book you want. If you don't, first of all, lots of time we have persons who have read. They have read and read and read. But do they understand what they're reading? Mm-hmm. Is the comprehension there and the application of what you have read into the practical side of life? Is it there? So I could tell you I read so-and-so book. Mm-hmm. But did it apply to my life? Did I apply the theories and the practice of that into my life, into the things that I'm doing? And if you have not done that, you fail in that area.
Miserably too.
Many persons have read things. Okay, for example, you could read about yoga, but if you don't practice yoga, it doesn't take you anywhere. I know persons who know all the slangs and all the names of all the positions in yoga. But ask them to do one yoga pose, they can't do it. They can't, but they read it.
Yeah.
And there's a difference. So knowing the theory and the practical side of it is something totally different. So it takes me to my next question, which is one of importance here. This is one of our regular listeners. This is somebody who is always interacting with the program. We'll call him Jim Brown, because that's the name he likes to go by. So Jim Brown asked the question, good evening, sir. Hope all is well. If time permits tonight, could you discuss the sexual culture shock that TNT, especially men, are experiencing with the Venezuelan immigrants? From their fashion, their views on sex, casual sex, sexual adventure, and even the way they treat their men, their husband, thanks. Would be tuning in later, or is it just their way of surviving and providing for their loved ones back home? Well, it's a number of things, and I have interviewed a lot of women who have come here to earn a living. Some of them know what they're coming into. Some of them, they choose the best. Their family would choose the best looking woman, the sexiest looking woman, and send she here. There's a reason behind that. In the 70s and 80s, we had that very same culture with the Guyanese.
Yeah.
And it's the very same thing repeating itself with the Venezuelan. The Guyanese would come here, they would send a nice, pretty, sexy woman. She'd get married to one brother in the village, and afterwards, five brothers in the village have wives from that same village in Guyana. It was a regular thing. And anybody who doubts me, do your research.
Yeah. I could recall that, yes.
Yes. They'll move into one village. One pretty girl will move into the village, she get married to a guy there, and all of a sudden she have about five sisters who are ready to get married.
Yeah.
They want to leave Guyana, they want to come to Trinidad. And that's what they did. Sometimes they use Trinidad as a stepping stone to go on to the United States or Canada. But that's what was done. The very same thing is happening with the Venezuelans. So it's a kind of cultural thing. Secondly, Spanish women treat their men differently. And that's a given. We have a different culture, the way we treat our men for, especially if it has to do with the races. A East Indian woman will treat her husband differently as opposed to an African woman, as opposed to a Chinese woman, as opposed to a Syrian woman. It's a different way. It's a cultural thing. There are things that one race will put up with more than the other. I'm not saying one is right and one is wrong. Please don't get me wrong. It's not a racial thing. It has to do with culture. It has to do with the culture of Trinidad and Tobago, because the culture of Trinidad and Tobago have shaped the Trinidadians and the Tobagonians.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yes.
And when you take a person out of the subcontinent and you take them out of Africa and you take them out of Asia and you bring them here, and Europe, and you bring them here, and they get infused with the Trinidad culture, the culture that they brought here is part of that infusion. So it changed. Just as how we have certain words that are part of the vocabulary of Trinidad and Tobago, it's the very same thing. The way a woman treats her husband, now again, it depends on your religion. Some religion demands that you treat them in a certain way. Some religion are more open to the way the wife treats the husband or the husband treats the wife. Now that's a religious thing. Culture. Some women, they go with the status quo. Now I'm not pinpointing any one religion, any one race, nothing. I'm not pinpointing. If it falls in your garden, it falls in your garden. Too bad for you. Oh, very good for you, however you want to take it. Mm-hmm. So you have to take that into consideration. You have to take into consideration the depth of involvement between the two persons, the love between each party. Some person will say, what is the moral and spiritual values with these things? What is it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Morality and spirituality goes out the door when you're horny. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, well, yes. That runs second.
It's not a neck and neck race.
No.
And many a times I've heard people use that about morality and spirituality and all those things, but they don't understand exactly what is going on mm-hmm. with a person's mentality when it comes to horniness, when it comes to the need for sexual satisfaction.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, folks, taking your time, it's now 19 minutes before 10 o'clock. You are on the inside of Sexplosion right here on Power 102.1 FM with the only sexologist in the Caribbean, Dr. Raj Ramdanin. We're going to take a break and we'll be right back with you. Stay tuned. I'm going to try that. I don't know. Need for thing, I'll cut it off. I feel it's wrong though.
Listen to our daily fat safety tips and get more information on our website and
social media platforms.
That's all the main videos. I listen.
And most of all,
I'll stop it one time.
Think twice. Powered by Vanguard, the Vehicle Management Corporation of Trinidad and Tobago.
Power 102
and Bull 94 is sponsored by Neil Massey Credit Union in an association with Computers and Controls.
Agricola Credit Union.
Arrive alive in the TTPS.
Think twice. For safer fetting, partying, and carnival season. Think twice. This Wednesday from 2 p.m., we examine and enjoy the work of two masters of the art of Calypso, the incomparable genius of serious humor in Calypso Spoiler, and Maestro, whose political and social commentary was biting. Guests include the Mighty Bomber, musical arranger, Alan Goddard, Calypsonian and close friend of Maestro, Kinte, brother of Maestro, Arthur Hume, Calypsonian protector, and others. Wednesday, 2 to 4 p.m. with Tony Fraser on Carnival Power 102, celebrating the masters.
Next rounds.
Give me another round, Michael. want to continue that you are making radio an experience by itself when you are on the inside of Sexplosion on Power 102 FM. The only sexologist in the Caribbean, Dr. Raj Ramanan of Total Image and the Adult Therapy Center, located in St. Augustine. Folks, our lines are open for those of you who might have questions for him. Feel free. Give him a call at 222-8255. Also at 612-8255. If you do decide that you want to send him a WhatsApp or a text or message, you can also do that on his private mobile at 740-1961. You can also send him messages on our messenger service at Power 102 FM.
So you have to take into consideration all these aspects, all the different things that would affect a person and their behavior. So when you have persons coming over here from a country where they need help, their mission is to do everything possible to make sure their family back home are taken care of. Because some of them have children, and especially if they are mothers, they're going to do anything. It doesn't matter what they have to do. If they have to pick up garbage on the side of the road, that's what they're going to do to earn that dollar to send back home. So you got to understand that. If they meet a man that is treating them well, this is one of the problems we are having in Trinidad and Tobago society right now, where a lot of men who are married get a person from Venezuela, a girlfriend, and suddenly they're taking care of that woman because the woman is taking care of them in many different ways, sexually and otherwise, the way they dress, the way they look, because Spanish woman is one thing with Spanish women. And I will tell you this point blank, Spanish women will do anything to look good, anything. Mm-hmm. They will inject their buttocks, they will inject their breasts, they will inject their lips, they will do every single thing. I remember when we had the clinic in Las Vegas and I was a consultant there. Women will come. They would come from all the Spanish-speaking areas just to do augmentation. Mm-hmm. And they don't care how much it costs. $20,000 to do the buttocks, they will do it. And they're talking about US dollars here. They will do it. Mm-hmm. They'll find the money to do that. They like to look good. They would like to dress in a provocative way. They like to entice man. They love to do that. And that's what they will do. So that's why the women in Trinidad have to step up to the plate. Why it is when a woman leaves Trinidad and go to the United States to live, she's in the gym, she's taking care of herself, she's looking good. When you're in Trinidad, you're not doing it.
Taking things for granted.
Taking things for granted. You think your man is not going astray? I'm not blaming the woman, but I'm telling you, you have to make yourself look good. You have to make your man want you. If your man marries you when you was 135 pounds and now you're 165, 180 pounds, you think he's going to love you the same way of that same feeling? Woman that is ideal for him is 135 pounds. Remember that. Always remember that. Same thing applies for women. But remember, women are more emotional. So a woman will stick with a man despite whatever changes take place. Even if he's bedridden, a woman will stick with the man.
Yeah.
Because it's more emotional. It's a love and devotion. And this is where love and devotion comes in. And so it's a cultural thing also. But a man, because we are visual, we are visually stimulated. God made us that way. Don't vex with us for that. Don't go and quarrel with your man and cuss your man if you watch a woman on the road. That is how we are wired. We are wired that way to look. For them, you see a nice woman is, it's like, it's seen a nice car. How many men does look at, you see a nice car going by, hey, we look at them rims, boy. How come we just notice them thing and women say, what rims you talking about? Women don't see those things. Look at a woman's ass and it's like, yeah, boy, shoo. And all the partners give her a bounce of that. Now the bounce is one and the woman has nothing to do with them, you know. The woman has absolutely nothing to do with what you give any partner about. Yeah, boy, nothing look good, eh?
Nothing looking well.
Because that's how we feel. So don't go blaming a man because of how we are naturally wired. So I tend to warn women, don't get angry if your man look at another woman. Because we are wired that way. Mm-hmm. Women are not wired that way, although they'll take a peep.
Yeah, they'll take a small thing.
Yeah, but they're not wired to stare on a woman and say,
men will continue the stare.
A woman will see everything in that quick look, and we don't see everything. You know, because we'll be focused on the part of the body that turns us on. Mm-hmm. If it's the feet, the buttocks, the breasts, the face, whatever turns us on.
Mm-hmm. But a woman could
take a bottom quick, rolling, boy.
A woman could take a quick look and give you a distinction from head to toe.
Not only head to toe, what down to the handbag that the other woman carrying? Mm-hmm. Would ever forget that?
As a matter of fact, she will even go further than that and mention the kind of shoes.
Shoes? The color of the shoes?
Yeah.
I have seen that many times, so don't tell me it doesn't exist. It is exactly that.
It does.
Sabrina says, yes. Sabrina says, so agree, it's real. Mm-hmm. Diane is on. C. Mary is on. Neela, how are you, my dear? Diane is on. Christina says, nice. Diana says, hi, good night, listening to your program. Neela says, very interesting. Good night, Doc. Ann Jr., my sister Chandra Katwaru is on. How are you? Melissa Sukram is on. Leslie Ann Sonachan is on. Darren, Janelle, Tasha, Janelle Imtiaz, my good friend. How are you? Kaviraj Singh is on. Sasha says, LOL. I guess she knows it's true. So these are the things that happen, and we have to be aware of that. Now, for those of you up the islands and those of you in Jamaica especially, for those of you suffering with dengue, I have an announcement to make in a while. That is something else we're tackling at the clinic with the doctor that is there. He has the cure for dengue. Mm-hmm. And it's something that he's been using for years, and I'll talk about it in a while. So I just want to send a reminder there for those of you who have an interest in that. Just tune in. I know we have a lot of listeners in Jamaica and also in New York of Jamaican
heritage.
Jamaican background.
Yeah.
This is blessings in a way.
I know, there we go.
Pure blessings. Pure you blessing. Have no idea how blessed it is.
Blessed.
It's like getting
okay.
Well, you wouldn't know it if I tell you, so I wouldn't tell you.
Okay, but since when we're getting all these blessings, what we'll do is take a break and we'll be right back with you. Stay tuned.
Wednesday, February 13, we're bringing the greatest show on earth, our carnival, in focus. We take a look at the art form, the business, the events, the architects, creative masters, and you, the patrons. We trace some of the history of carnival, where it is today, and where it's heading. Join in on the discussions as we speak with officials, legends, and promoters. Have your say before the show. Send your messages and contributions online and through our app. Power102FM.com. In Focus, Carnival 2K19, this Wednesday, February 13th. Welcome to Carnival 2019 on main stage Power 102, celebrating the masters.
I will finish the last along there.
A celebration of Trinbeholden culture. Come and enjoy the sweet enticing sound of pan. And live pan coverage. The Pepperama semifinals, the Pepperama finals, and the Carnival Lanyard. The party season is here. Temple Prelims and Semis, Calypso Fiesta, National Junior Calypso Monarch Finals, and Terrific Thursday, celebrating the Masters, playing now on Power 102.
I knew I had to be on stage. I felt this is a place.
Celebrating the Masters, ticket giveaways for Army Fat and more. Interesting historical features like Origins of the Mass, Folk Tales, Fables, and Legends, Calypso Stories, Characters of Carnival. And to keep you updated and in the know, our Carnival Calendar 2019. Along with so much more, celebrating the Masters. Playing now on Power 102.
Power 102, empowering you.
This carnival is my fat, your fat, Army fat. The safest bet in carnival.
Army fat.
We just had the top of the top. Oh, I like you too, brother. You good or no?
Good to throw away.
I now see where they got the idea to name tires Goodyear. For 8 minutes and then we go to the top of the hour. I'll do that, the top of the hour in the break. Want to tell you that when it comes to sex education, we are always one step ahead. You are on the inside of Sexplosion right here on Power 102.1 FM. The guru of sex education, Dr. Raj Ramanan of Total Image and the Adult Therapy Center. Just to remind you once again that our lines are open for those of you who would like to interact with him via the telephone. 612-228-255, also at 612-8255. For those of you sending in your text messages and your WhatsApp messages, you can also do that on his private mobile at 740-1961. You can also send in your messages on our website at Power102FM. We will receive and air it for you. Yeah.
Before I go further, I have to say a pleasant good night to a group that is very informative and interesting to follow. Vice City, for all the fine folks at Vice City, all the pervs, Vice, as they call themselves.
Vice City.
All the pervs, Vice City is a WhatsApp group. Mm-hmm. Pleasant good night to you. Thank you for tuning into the program, and I like the entertainment that you provide. I like some of the things that you all say, and I really like some of the things that you all post. But again, it's all part of my life, so what can I say? I have to say a special good evening to a friend of mine for 18 years.
18 years.
A person know who she is.
Yeah.
She have me smiling from ear to ear. That's all I'm going to say. And a good friend of mine over in Suriname. Sorat Kumar, how are you, my friend? Dear Dr. Raj, how does work stress influence have effect on your sex life? Well, stress has a terrible effect on your sex life. Mm-hmm. Once you are stressed out, you're mentally, physically, and emotionally drained. It affects the quality of your erection. It affects your concentration. And we need to concentrate when we're making love. You can't be making love to a woman and thinking about how you're paying the bills.
No.
You cannot be making love to a woman and thinking about, I wonder if the truck coming tomorrow with the goods to deliver. Boy. You can't be doing that. You have to concentrate on what you're doing. You must make that woman feel the passion that's coming from you.
You wouldn't be in it 100% anyhow.
You have to have the passion. So once you have stress-related and work-related stress affecting your mind, it's going to affect the quality of your erection. It's going to affect the quality of your lovemaking. You are going to have difficulties in relating to the person. The chemistry will not be right, and even your performance will not be 100%. So you got to take those things into consideration when you are engaging in anything sexual with your husband or your wife. And know what you can and cannot do, and know the extent at which you can go. So those are the things that you have to be focused on. You have to focus on you, and you have to focus on your partner. When you're performing, for example, if you're performing oral sex on a woman, or a woman is performing oral sex on a man, she has to love that penis as though it's just an extension of her, you know. The same thing with you. You have to love that vagina as though it's an extension of you, your mouth, and everything that you can do. That's why I tell persons, learn the techniques and learn all the things that you're supposed to know to do it right.
Yes.
Learn your partner's body.
Practice makes perfect.
Correct. So that answers your question, I hope. I'm sure if you have any other question, you'll... Now, remember, folks, this program could go until 12, depending on if you interact with the program, if you send your messages, or if you call in. The best thing to do is call in, because I like to hear your voice. And I want to know, we have somebody listening out there. Although we have people on Facebook and whatnot, give us a call. Send some information. I'm getting to you, Nisa. Don't worry, I'm getting to you. I have about 25 persons ahead of you. Okay, this is Steve. I got that message. Thank you very much. Good night, Raj. I have a question. Is there anything like a female impotency? Is there, can you mean, it's not, so anytime you use the word impotency, it means to say there's no coming back. Mm-hmm. When you tell a man he's impotent, there's no coming back. There's no such thing as impotence unless you have been castrated or something like that.
Mm-hmm. Right.
There is sexual dysfunction. And if there is sexual dysfunction, if there's a low enough libido, if you don't have that drive, there are things that you can do to bring it back. You got to find the root cause of anything that you have. I've been preaching this for years. It's second nature to me to say it. But yes, there's in-depth study of the individual as to what is happening and why it's being caused, what are the cause of it, and the effects on the human mind.
Yeah.
You can't be stressed out about where your next meal coming from and feel to make love. You might just have sex. Any two fools could have sex. A penis and a vagina could have sex. But making love is a different thing. Mm-hmm. Getting into the mindset and getting into the rhythm and the movement of the person that you're making love to is a different thing. The feeling changes with stress and other things. If you have a low libido, how are you going? Okay, it's like this. You put a penis in a vagina, you have a movement. The turgidity comes from what you're doing, the movement. And I'm talking about as you age and you have other things affecting you and whatnot. And what the person does to react to you, the sound that she makes, the movement of the vagina, the movement of the body, all these things play an important part in the stimulation that you get. So that's why when you're making love to someone, you must be attuned to that person, the person must be attuned to you.
Oh yeah.
And especially if it is your spouse is supposed to know what will turn you on or not. And those say something that wouldn't turn you on, or don't have a quarrel before you go and have sex. The stress of that alone, you can't enjoy sex.
Oh, no.
Pleasant good evening to Farina, Kim, Rina, Janelle. Good night, Dr. Raj. How are you? Rio Claro locked on. And Rio Claro is always locked
always,
on.
Eh?
All the good folks in Rio Claro, pleasant good evening to you. Jenny is also locked on. Good night, Usha from Rio Claro is locked on. So, good night, Dr. Raj and Junior. Fantastic program. Keep up the good work from Sexy Alicia. Oh, you tell me you're sexy, but I haven't seen your picture, so I don't know if you're sexy. Mm-hmm. Or that might just be a label you put it on yourself.
Yeah.
We have to put that label on you.
Yeah.
Isn't that so?
But of course. Because first time I've heard her locked on.
No, she's been locked on a few times. Jennifer says, topic for tonight, role-playing and toys in the bedroom. Good evening. We're locked on, meaning she and her husband are locked on. Role-playing, that's another thing. Role-playing is very important. You know, it's a standard joke with me that my wife, she does everything. Every single thing. She's a devoted wife. She does what she has to do. She gives me room to be who I want to be.
Mm-hmm.
I have no restrictions on anything. My wife don't quarrel with me about something. If something bothers her, she tells you about it, and you have to know what to do to change it. That's it.
Yeah.
That is, it's as simple as that with her.
She will say something.
She will not quarrel about it.
She will leave it like that.
She will not quarrel about it. She will tell it in a very stern voice.
Yeah.
What it is bothering her. If you're overdoing, for example, sometimes I sit down and I'm looking at my phone and I'm having dinner or something, and we together, and she's like, I think you need to put down that phone. And
that's it.
That's it.
Yeah.
It could be whoever takes in. That's it. It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
You know? But she will tell you what she has to tell you, and that's it.
She's straightforward.
Very straightforward. And she'll tell you, if you vex afterwards, that's your business. Me, vex, I just tell you what I have to tell you, and I move on.
Yeah.
And she has never made an issue of the things that I do, the interaction that I have with all these women and whatnot. That, as a matter of fact, I'll tell you a story. Once we were making love, my wife and I. Got a call in the middle of it. Phone, I didn't answer the phone. My cell phone. I have cell phone when it first came out of Trinidad. I have numbers in the 680. That's the first cell phone number that came out in Trinidad. A lot of people feel it's 678, but it was 680. Then it went to 681, and then it dropped to 678. So I have a cell phone. It was ringing. But it kept on ringing, and I said, this has to be important. So I stopped what I was doing, and I answered the phone. And I called the person's name out. Because my wife is there, I called the person's name out. It's a female. And I told her, I said, okay, you'll see me soon. And I hung up the phone, stopped what I was doing. I told my wife, so-and-so isn't a problem, I'm going to help her. Left home, this is about 9, 10 o'clock in the night. Eh?
Mm-hmm.
Went home, left home, went to her home, deal with whatever I had to deal with her, took the relevant persons that she needed to deal with her issue. So when I came back home, my wife was awake, which is a strange thing. She normally go to sleep. So she's like, I want you to do me a favor tomorrow. I said, what? She said, I want you to get a cell phone tomorrow, and all those friends and women and things you have outside here, give them that number. And promise me when you come home, that phone's remain downstairs.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how I have a 740 number. That's all she told me.
Yeah.
And then she asked me, she's okay? I said, yes. Everything is settled. Mm-hmm. She have no problems tomorrow. But she knows that's the kind of person I am. If somebody calls me for help, I'm up and I gone. Afterwards, I face the consequences, whatever it may be. I've always been straight up with that. So it doesn't matter if it's a male or a female, I will answer, and if I have to go, I will go. And she knows that. She knows that's my characteristics, and that's the way I move. And when I come back home, I would make sure that I explain whatever it is to you.
Yeah.
Sometimes it will be the next day because she will go to sleep. But that night, she was kind of pissed off, and she told me, make sure you get a phone and give it to whoever you want.
But that is what I love about a female, that's understanding. They tell you what they think at that particular moment, and
that's it. It's done there.
And they back to normal.
So I know a lot of people are fearful of her. They don't like to come into contact with her because, and a lot of people like to meet her because they just tell her, you use a hell of a woman. Mm-hmm. I've had friends, I have friends who are very much into these kind of things, dealing with people and whatnot. And when they hear about my wife, they say, I have to meet her. You know? They'll leave whatever they're doing and go and meet her, you know, and shake her hand and say, you deserve a trophy. But that's how she is.
Yeah,
and there's no denying that.
That's a mentality.
Yeah, and you know that from way back when.
Oh, yes.
So I have no issue with that. But the issue is, what do you do with a gem like that? What do you do? So the standard joke between us is that the day you want somebody to help you in the house, I want a French maid with a very short skirt, no panty. And she have to be dressing high. And that's a standard joke. Mm-hmm. No matter who is by us, whatever, I always say that. And she knows that. But she knows if it has to come to be, it will be.
Mm-hmm.
I will make it happen because that's the kind of individual I am. If I have to make something happen, it will happen.
Mm-hmm.
And she knows I'm capable of that.
Is a mindset person.
Well, I create whatever needs to be created for things to happen, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Because once I think about it, it's going to happen. And she knows that. She
once
tells
you,
me that.
So in other words, once you put
what
your mind
I put
to something,
my mind to something, it's going to happen.
Going
and
to
she
happen.
Tells me that. She said, once you want something to happen, it's going to happen and nobody's going to stop you.
Hmm.
It has been like that since we were in high school. She knows that. She knows me from Form 1 to Form 5. She knows everything that I wanted to do. As a matter of fact, I broke even my own promise to myself and asked her to get married earlier. And she said, no. She said, didn't you say you wanted to do so and so and so before you got married? Go do it and I'll wait for you. Because I always made it clear what I wanted to do.
But that's the beauty about your marriage especially. There's an understanding with both of you guys.
But it's an understanding based on trust. And it's an understanding based on a simple thing. Tell the person as much as they want to know. And she's very straight about it. I don't want no details. Just tell me the basic.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm done with that.
Mm-hmm. And you move
so
on.
If I go into Lyme and I go in south to meet somebody, I'll say I go in south to Lyme. She don't want to know who I'm going to line with, how long I'm going to line or whatever. You're coming back late? Okay. There'll be food in the oven or whatever. Talk done. And that's the way it is. There's no quarrel, there's no hassle, there's nothing in that. So I'm not stressed out by that.
That's a great understanding.
And that's why I could be very open about saying these things. I tell it tonight, I tell her, I say, girl, one of these days you have to come on the program. She say, you're going to cut into my sleeping time.
Mm-hmm.
You're crazy. Or she don't listen to this program. Even when this is a Facebook Live, it's on Facebook Live and it's recorded and she don't even look back at it. Oh, today I was looking back at last night's program and she came into the office and she didn't bother to even listen. It doesn't matter to her.
Yeah. That's great understanding.
It does not matter to her what I say or...
That's a beautiful understanding.
As a matter of fact, people tell her what I say.
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah.
All the time.
Mm-hmm.
Like sometimes they come and they meet her for the first time and whatnot. They say, you know, your husband was talking about you about that. She'll just smile and walk away.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it. It's like water on a duck back. It doesn't do anything to her.
That doesn't...
No. All she cares about is the relationship that we have and what we do and her family.
That's
full
great.
Stop. Done.
That's,
everything done.
That's great understanding.
So, getting back to the question that was asked, toys in the bedroom, why not? It's like the woman who says that her husband say, based on the church that he goes to, toys are not allowed in the bedroom. There's nothing intimidating about toys. You can use toys as supplemental to whatever you're doing with your partner. It could be something that enriches you and your relationship.
Yeah.
If done properly, and if you need to use a toy, why not use it with your wife and or use it with your husband so you get the maximum benefit out of it?
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that what you're supposed to do? Make it part of the love, make it
yeah.
part of the role play, make it part of whatever you're doing.
Yeah.
But the role playing is a nice thing, you know, especially when a person... You see, I can't answer that question while I'm doing the program because it's going to take a lot of effort for me to answer that question. So I do not know how to answer that question right away.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, folks, taking your time. It's now 10 minutes after 10 o'clock. You're on the inside of Sexplosion on Power 2.1 FM. We're going to take a break and come right back. But just to remind you that on the roads, safety comes first. So think twice and save a life. Put down the phone, it's the law. Do you know that once a device is in your hand, phone or otherwise, when the car is moving, you are breaking the law. So you've got to put the phone down. You can't reply at all if you're dead, so pull aside and you can answer that message. You wouldn't drive with your eyes closed, would you? So don't do it when your eyes are on the phone. Pull aside or answer your party later. Hands-free or headsets when you're driving, so when you need to, both hands can be on the wheel. Powered by Vemcot, the Vehicle Management Corporation of Trinidad and Tobago, Power 102, Boom 94, in association with their computers and controls, Alive, Arrive Alive, and the TTPS.
Are the problems and destructive anxieties of today tearing you apart? If there was ever a time to readjust your priorities and refocus your vision, it's now. Join Pastor Wayne Sampson on the Vision for Devotional Program every Monday from 5:30 to 6 a.m. right here on Power 102 FM. Jesus is the only one who can give you peace in the midst of today's storm.
Welcome to Carnival 2019 on main stage Power 102, celebrating the Masters.
And you can collab along there.
A celebration of Trinidadian culture. Come and enjoy the sweet enticing sound of Pan. And live Pan
Carnival.
Semi-finals, the Panorama Finals, and the Carnival Lanyard.
My good.
The party season is here. Of the National Extempo Prelims and Semis, Calypso Fiesta, National Junior Calypso Monarch Finals, and Terrific Thursday, celebrating the Masters, playing now on Power 102.
I knew I had to be on stage. I felt this is a place.
Celebrating the Masters, ticket giveaways for Army Fat and more. Interesting historical features like Origins of the Mass, Folk Tales, Fables, and Legends, Calypso Stories, Characters of Carnival, and to keep you updated and in the know, our Carnival Calendar 2019. Along with so much more, celebrating the Masters. Playing now on Power 102.
Power 102, empowering you.
This Carnival.
Well, I can tell you that nobody does better what we do best when it comes to sex education every Thursday and Friday evenings right here on Power 102 FM. May I remind you that this program may contain material that is not suitable for children. Parental guidance are therefore advised. You are listening to Sexplosion on Power 102 FM. The only sexologist in the Caribbean, Dr. Raj Ramanan, our Total Image and the Adult Therapy Center located in St. Augustine. Our lines are open for those of you who would love to interact with him via the telephone. Feel free, 222-8255. Also at 612-8255. If you do decide that you want to send him a WhatsApp or a text message, you can also do that on his private mobile, 740-1961.
So again, pleasant good evening to the group, the WhatsApp group, Vice City. Nisa says, good night, Dr. Raj. It's Nisa. By the way, one of my friends is going through something. She said that she go by her boyfriend sometime on weekend, but not about a month. He keep telling her she can't come on weekend. She wants to know why he's doing that. He tells her that he have a lot going on, but he sees her sometime in the week. So she wants to know what she should do. Well, ask him what's going on. Yeah. I can't answer that question. Only the person could answer that question. There may be a legitimate reason for him not wanting her there. He may be going through some problems at work. He may be going through some challenges. We do know that when you are stressed out and you have challenges, it's going to affect your sexual performance. Mm-hmm. So the only way she can know the truth is if she actually have a conversation with him.
And then again, on the other hand, it all depends on what kind of job he's doing.
Yeah, exactly, the type of job that he's doing. Somebody says, Dr. Raj is very interesting. It is my first time listening to him. Thanks for sharing. And this is Avi, is part of, I think he's one of the administrators of the group. So guys, it's good to have you all. Talk about sexual anxiety and how that relates to an erection, if you're knowledgeable on that. If I'm knowledgeable about that, I deal with that every single day.
Every day.
Every single day, I deal with that at the clinic. Persons who have sexual anxiety, what happens with them is that they're unable to perform because a chemical is released by the brain. That's why you have blockers for that chemical. But of course, that blocker for that chemical, you have to be very careful because it could cause other problems in your body. I'm not going to call the name of the blocker because some persons might want to go and get the blocker and use it, but it could cause other harm to the individual. So it's my responsibility not to talk, not to give the name of the blocker, but there are blockers that you can use. But sexual anxiety comes about when you're unsure of yourself, when you don't have the requirements or the experience to do the things that you want to do, when you're over anxious or over excited about your partner, when you want to do things perfectly. And don't ever think about doing sex perfectly, because nobody's perfect in sex. You do sex to the best of your ability based on your experiences, and you learn as you go along. Sex is a learning experience. You learn from every single person that you make love to. I'm not saying to have multiple partners or many partners, but the more partners you have, the more things you learn.
Yeah.
That's just the way it is. Well, somebody like Junior, he have an encyclopedia of knowledge.
No, but you don't. But you don't make love to the same woman the same way.
No, you don't. You don't. Because and I'll tell you something about sexual anxiety.
Completely.
I'll tell you something about sexual anxiety. There's a simple cure for it, you know. That chemical that is released by your brain into your bloodstream, that shuts off your sexual function. It makes your penis die. It remains 20 minutes in your bloodstream, you know.
20 minutes.
But if you continue and say, oh God, I wonder if I go fail, but I wonder what she's thinking, I wonder, oh God, this thing is getting up. It continues to be released by the brain. So for them it releases and you fail, simply go to sleep. Lie down with your partner, hug up. Women like to hug up.
Oh yeah.
Hug up, make love, kiss you all on your neck and thing and say, darling, I kind of tired, let's take a nap.
Yeah.
And believe me, I guarantee you're going to wake up with a hard on. I guarantee.
That's guaranteed.
Once you wake up from that sleep.
Because of that rest.
That power nap. That 20 minutes of sleeping, that chemical is going to work itself out of your system. That sexy woman is sleeping next to you. You're going to feel her body heat. You're going to feel her breathing. You're going to feel that sexiness emitting from her. Of course, the chemistry is going to be there, and you're going to wake up with a hard on and jump on the box.
So the rest basically is recharging your battery.
The rest is to get rid of that chemical from your bloodstream.
So
there's simple ways of solving the problem, but if you continuously have the problem, there are ways that we treat at the adult therapy center to get rid of it. It's psychological. It's physical, it's emotional, it's mental.
Well, just to remind you that you are listening to Sexplosion on Power 102 FM, the guru of sex education in the Caribbean, Dr. Raj Ramananan of Total Image and the Adult Therapy Center. Folks, don't forget, for those of you who might have doubt about something sexual on your mind, feel free, our lines are open for those of you who would love to interact with him via the telephone 222-8255, also at 612-8255. You can send in your messages for those of you who don't like hearing your voice on air. You can send in your messages on his private mobile, your WhatsApp, your text messages at 740-1961.
Unfortunately, I know who she's talking about. So she asked the second part of the question. What if he wakes up with the hard-on and still gets the anxiety and it goes down again? It's not anxiety, that is chemical dependency.
Chemical dependency.
I know the individual, I know what has happened.
Anything
that you abuse, anything that you have done wrongly to the body, anything that you put into the system that is produced naturally, you have a shutdown of that in your body. So you'll have spikes, you'll have certain things happening, but because of that chemical dependency, you need the chemical in your body. So the anxiety is not the problem. The anxiety triggers it. But because there are damages that are done by other things to the flow, to the nerves, to the capillaries, all the things that you need for good sexual function, that is what is causing the problem. So something like that has to be treated. And this is where the technicality comes in. If you know the individual, for example, if you come and sit in front of me, and I know the kind of whoring life that you've had, and you tell me some of the things that are happening to you, I will simply tell you you need to go to the mount and do some prayers. And that's the only way it's going to help you.
That's the only
to
way
raise the dead. But thank God it's not you.
No, well, hey.
But if it's another person and they give me, that's why as a sexologist you ask many questions to arrive at a reasoning behind it.
Oh, okay.
There must be a reason. There must be a background. What is the backstory? Everything has a backstory. What is the backstory to this? What are the catalysts of these things happening? So a person who's faced with these challenges, and there are a number of things that has happened previously, and I'm sure some of the things that I've found out, she don't even know it.
Okay.
Right? Because of the arena that the person's in. And the interaction that person has with other people that I know. So there's so much things that could go wrong with a person. And that's why sometimes I reach out to help people. But they don't give me all the information and I have to do my own investigation. I love to investigate. I ask questions upon questions. When I'm finished with a person,
yeah,
I could pinpoint exactly what is causing the problem. But I don't jump to conclusion because I have to do the chemical test now. The lab has to do a chemical test to reinforce what I'm thinking. And then I find a solution for the individual. But everybody wants a quick fix, you know, because, you know, everybody wants a quick fix so that they can go and have sex right away. Like I had a patient today. Lots of problems. Well, you don't have to put on work list this evening. You could give me something for it. I don't give shortcuts.
No.
I don't. Because the minute you fail, the first person you're going to blame is me.
You're
going to
get the rap for it.
Mm-hmm. I am going to be blamed. Anyway, persons are going to say, Dr. Raj don't know what he's doing.
Anyway, folks, taking overtime, 21 minutes after 10 o'clock, and the quality nighttime program is here on Power 102 FM, your number one all-around station when it comes to talk and music. We're going to take a break and we'll be right back with you. Stay tuned.
Tune in to Game Time this Saturday for what promises to be a fiery edition. Trinidad and Tobago Super League and current TTFA board member Keith Looklaw will be in studio. That's right, he'll address the current lack of transparency in the TTFA, home of football, the high-handed approach by
only,
the TTFA president.
Only one
why
out,
after
eh?
3 years, there are no subcommittees appointed, why the slow pace in sorting out financial issues, and much more. So tune in to Game Time just after the midday news on Power 102.1 FM this Saturday.
I want to continue that we are giving our listeners what they want and expect from a good radio program when it comes to sex education right here on Power 102 FM with the guru of sex education, Dr. Raj Ramana. Well, feel free, folks. Our lines are open for those of you who would like to interact with him at 222-8255, also at 612-8255. You can send in your WhatsApp text messages on his private mobile, 740-1961. You're listening to a program that's educational, informative, and of course, entertaining, right here on Power 102 FM.
Izzy, I wonder why it's green, and I need to know whose. Anyway, I was shown a photograph today,
mm-hmm,
and I saw the problems immediately.
Oh, okay.
Now, I am trained in many areas. One of the areas that I'm trained in is sports.
Mm-hmm.
And I am official IFBB judge. And there are things that we look for when we are judges. There are things that we don't judge, but we look for it. We look for it, but you're not allowed to judge it.
Mm.
But it gives you an indication of the individual. And all those things play a part in what you become later on in life. As a sexologist, it all marries into what I'm doing. So I'm thankful that I was in that arena for so many years and I got that knowledge and
that experience.
Yeah, and that experience, and here I am today. Where are we? Anna says, good night, you guys. Yes, always listening. And somebody sent something especially for you, Junior, and for the young lady who accuses me of sharing things with you. I told her that I only share things with you that people allow me to share, so I'm sharing this with you. That's your Rio Claro family.
Oh, beautiful.
Yes, 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 yes. Savitri, thank you for that.
That's why I love my people in Rio Claro.
Yes, you must love your people in Rio Claro. Puran, you need to get in touch with us. And yes, we are doing deliveries for those of you who are in the Southland. You can call the stores, you can order your stuff, and it will be delivered to you.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll be doing that at all the stores for Valentine's and otherwise. But so we are doing deliveries. Question, is hair removal cream safe to use around the penis or vagina? I will test it on a soft part of your body first to see if you get any chemical burns. If you do get chemical burns, no, don't use
Can't
it.
Can't use.
Nope. Better if you wax or shave.
Mm.
Okay, thank you. I'll let her know. That's true. This is from Nisa. Oh my God. Thank you, Izzy. You just made my night.
Listen, it's not even Sunday morning.
10 times over. Chris says, well, he would be listening. My good friend Chris Garcia. I hope you are on.
Yeah.
I hope you're on. Jenny, she's on. Lorenzo. I had this young woman telling me how she loved me. I used to send money for her, but my mom came and died, so I couldn't send no money no more. For a little while, I gave her my sister and tell her my sister that she loves me. And she's not a scammer like the other girls. I have never seen this girl, but used to send money for her. What should I do? She's 24 and I am 61. You think she loves me? She loves your money. Mm-hmm. I know she loves you, but I know she loves your money. So.
He's 61.
And she's 24.
24.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
The number for my office is 645-4543. That number again is 645-4543 if you need to contact me. For those of you who need to make an appointment to see the doctor concerning diabetes, the treatment for diabetes that he has, 645-9829 or 645-4543. Call, make the appointment for this Wednesday coming.
Wednesday coming.
Wednesday. And he also sent me something, let me pull it up here, which I need to address. The elimination of all dengue, or elimination of death from dengue and dengue hemorrhagic fever in TNT and by extension the rest of the world. Of course, he is doing this. Mm-hmm. He has invented or he has produced something that works very well for that. He has all his certification and everything. He's a medical doctor. But because of the challenges that he faced with the medical board and other thing, he has to be careful what he says and what he does. Because, you know, like everything else, if you find a way to do things, like I can give you a good example for the cure for herpes. Mm-hmm. Because this came about many years ago by these scientists, and the lead scientist, as I told you, he came to Trinidad to talk about it. They had to go underground in the Bahamas, produce it in vials, and people will go to the Bahamas and buy it and bring it back personally for themselves, but they couldn't bring it into the U.S. until they got an FDA number, and they had to reproduce it in a different form to be used.
Okay. Yeah,
those are the challenges you face in the medical world, throughout the world. It doesn't matter where you are. So you have to be very careful about that and what you do. Wow. Thank you very much, Anna. No, that one I can't share with you. She didn't say to share it. So if she didn't say to share it, I can't.
No, because I see the your phone shaking.
My phone is shaking. My hands are shaking.
No, oh, the hands. Okay.
No, Junior. A pleasant good evening to my cousin Neil. How are you? Maria, Rina, Joy, Michelle, Mira, my other cousin. How are you? Donnell, Shanti, Chanel, Jason. Hey, Jason, how are you? I was looking out for something for you, Jason, and I see it. The disappointment here. Jason is like the newspaper of Trinidad and Tobago.
Mm-hmm,
he's always current with everything that's happening.
He usually fills you in on what's happening.
Yeah, and there's one thing I've been looking out from him and I can't get it. Mm. Good night, Doctor. Great program all the time. Zaida of Tonapona is always locked on. Zaida, she's a long time listener.
Zaida?
Yeah, many years ago. Wow. Good night, why? Doctor, why do some men play with their penis, their dick before having sex? Because they need to stimulate it. Yes, that's why they like to have a good blowjob before sex.
Mm-hmm. Yes, so they're on the runway.
Yes, so that they can get a proper erection. Mm-hmm. What most porn stars, they always jock in the prick before they have sex.
Mm-hmm.
That is a normal thing to do. Mm-hmm. Because it's part of what you're supposed to do, to stimulate yourself.
Yeah, because if you just jump into it, that wouldn't make any sense at all.
No, it wouldn't make any sense. Mm-hmm. You're going to fail. Mm-hmm.
Anyway, folks, taking your time, it's 29 minutes after 10 o'clock. The magic of sex education, taking it to a whole new level. Inside Power 102 FM on this Friday evening with the guru of sex education, Dr. Raj Ramanan of Total Image and the Adult Therapy Center, where he do treats all sexual dysfunctions in both male and female. You can interact with him via the telephone. He's in the studio sitting right next to me here.
I am.
Watching the white of his eyes. 2228255. Also at 612-8255. You can also send in your messages on our website at Power102FM. We will receive and air it for you. Yeah.
There are many challenges that we face in all situations that we're dealing with, especially sexual situations. Sometimes we need to step back, step away from it. That's why you have counseling and that's why you have sex therapy, you know. You need to step away and have someone independently look at it and find a solution for you, because you may not have the answers, you may not have the solution, you may not find a way to deal with it properly. So that's why you need that. You need to have those things done, otherwise you find yourself in a lot of problems. Some person starts off in a relationship on the wrong note. For example, if you start a relationship with a lie, there's no coming back.
No, there's no coming back.
Many an individual have started off their relationship with a lie. So you're living with that lie all the time, and you're trying to figure out, how do I tell my partner, how do I tell my girlfriend, how do I tell my boyfriend that I started off with a lie?
Yeah. And you have to be, as a matter of fact, what happens to you is that you have to be thinking all the time, because you don't want to mess up from what you have said before. Whereas with the truth, I mean, you're free and you're comfortable.
That's why when somebody asks me a question, and this is one of the things that I always say, anytime a person tell you, I don't lie, they just lie. They just tell a lie. Everybody lies in one way or the other. But if you ask me a question about myself, if you ask me a question about my relationship, if you ask me a question about who I am and what I do, I give you the answer. It's for you to deal with it, you know. And a lot of people can't deal with me and deal with the answers because they can't fathom it.
You know what I cannot handle? Somebody telling you a lie and they say, it's just a little white lie.
There's no white lie and black lie. It's a lie. You lie. Exactly. Don't tell me it's a little lie. You lie.
A white lie.
You damn lie.
So
lie is a lie.
I want to know if it comes in colors.
Lies don't come in colors. Lies are lies. Once you have told a lie, you're capable of telling another lie.
Yeah, but the thing about it is, once you start, it's very uncomfortable.
You don't start a relationship with a lie. Anytime you start a relationship with a lie, you're in trouble. You're in serious trouble.
You are in trouble,
Stick to the truth.
You better come straight forward.
The only time a lie is acceptable, and it's quoted in the Gita, it's stated in the Gita, a lie to save a human life is worth more than 1,000 truth.
To save a life.
A lie to save a life is worth more than 1,000 truth. And that is in the Gita, the Bhagavad Gita. So if somebody rush in here and say, is that Junior behind there? I want to shoot him. They're not Junior. Junior just left and he went out the road. I just save your life. Which is a lie.
Yes.
Because you're sitting there.
Well, I can understand.
That's how it's meant.
I could understand something like that.
But that's the only time the lie is accepted.
But thanks for saving me.
Thanks for saving me. The guy running down the road now, you see, he just left.
Her husband.
Somebody husband. What? Oh, my.
No, I'm just kidding.
Oh, my. Thank you very much for that. It's an eye-opener. It's a wake-up-upper.
Oh, yeah.
A wake-up-upper.
Kind of pop your eyes
It's
open.
Better than the tea that I have here. Love it. There are certain things I love, you know. And when I get it, it's like, you know, it's like dark chocolate.
Because you see, I'll tell you something. It is done in good taste. And as you mentioned chocolate, my son is a lover of cocoa.
The one that I gave you?
No, the one that you mentioned that he. So I say, you love cocoa? He say yes. That the one that they picked from the tree. I say, Uncle Raj and myself always talk about
I'll bring one for him.
He loves it.
When I go up to my partner's estate, I'll bring one for him. My wife loved that also. Oh, yes. Sunday, Bloody Sunday. Remember that song? Do you?
Yeah.
You too?
You too.
Yeah.
Even though this is off the track record a bit.
We always go off the track.
As you're speaking about music, I was watching an interview with Phil Collins today, where he's making a comeback after 20-something
years.
And he was asked, what is the worst tune that he don't like to perform in all the music that he has? And the song he picked was Groovy Kind of Love. He said he don't like performing it at all. They were shocked because they find it's such a beautiful song. But he said if there's only one song he don't like to perform, is that particular one.
But I told you the history of one of his songs and the person he sang about that. I saw that person.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But his wife left him and he went into... anyhow, we talked...
depression.
Yeah. Yeah.
The normal thing that has happened when your wife gone, yeah, or your husband go.
Yeah, he was off.
That's not an easy thing, you know, dealing with those type of issues.
No.
There are things that could destroy a person very easily, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well,
there are things that will destroy a person very easily.
Mm-hmm. As a matter of fact, when you're thinking in terms of the female species, a simple thing that they can do, you know, you will go over your hinges and you can get vexed, but they could just move this from here and put it here, and it's a whole, I mean,
a big bacchanal.
Your whole life tumble.
Especially if they're OCD.
Mm-hmm. OCD.
Yeah.
Okay.
There are some women you can't mess up their house.
Mm-hmm.
You can't do that. You can, if you move a plate, you better wash it and put it back exactly where you find it.
I know people like that.
I'll tell you something. I think I'll finish up early tonight because nobody's calling and whatnot. So, and I have a lot of entertainment for myself.
Oh, you're getting live entertainment.
I'm getting live entertainment that I'm just savoring here and packing it aside and putting it in the compartment that it belongs to.
Yeah.
So that I can take a look at it later.
You're putting, oh, as a saver.
Yeah, no, to save it.
No, yeah. You're always good to save things, you know.
Always good to.
Yeah.
Like I said, we have another 25 minutes before we wrap up.
Anyway, folks, taking our time, 25 minutes before 11 o'clock. The magic of sex education. I can tell you, we are giving our listeners what they want and expect from a good radio program when it comes to sex education right here on Power 102 FM. Our lines are open for those of you who would love to interact with Dr. Raj. I know for a fact that a lot of you have sexual problems, but I don't know what is the reasons why you don't want to call and get help for it. So if you are one out of 10, what you can do, Dr. Raj is sitting right next to me here now. You can pick up the phone, give him a call at 222-8255, also 612-8255. Okay, so you don't want to hear yourself on air, right? Okay, I could understand something like that. You can send him a WhatsApp or a text message on his private mobile, 740-1961. Yeah.
And thank God it's a private mobile, and because the things that has come on my phone.
Well, I can just, as a matter of fact.
It's like this, when my phone goes off, like if it's downstairs, my wife will say, your phone.
Mm-hmm. No one I can imagine.
I'll say, no, I'll look at it later.
Mm-hmm. Well,
but she will never pick it up or look at it.
Mm-hmm.
Never.
No.
And we, that's how we live.
No, I don't.
I will never pick up my wife's phone and look at
as
it.
A man, I don't believe in that.
I don't believe in that at all. Your phone is your private thing.
That's
you. That's I don't have to look at that at all.
What I don't like, and I find is really changing the world, is that families don't have conversation
anymore. Okay, they have to sit down and text.
They sit down, as soon as you get home, everybody's on their phone.
No.
That, you know,
I don't text my children. I call them. I make sure I talk to them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, but everybody picks up the phone and they sit around and they're looking. And
it's going to get worse. It's not going to get better. It's going to get worse as time goes by.
You're having dinner on a table, a private dinner. Everybody's, by the time they eat the ice cream for the dessert, as they take a swallow, they look at the phone.
And they're running to get to the food.
Yeah.
Anything on the WhatsApp here? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So the question was asked. So getting back to what the doctor does, there'll be a series of things that he's going to be treating, like, for example, stroke, diabetes, dengue, high cholesterol, injuries that cause you to have sexual dysfunction, things that I can work hand in hand with at the Adult Therapy Center in St. Augustine. No, he's not seeing anyone in DB as yet.
Mm-hmm.
It will be strictly in St. Augustine for now until we establish the clinic there with what he's doing, and then we move it to Davie. So if you want to see the doctor, you can't do it in Davie, you have to do it at St. Augustine.
Yeah.
And for those of you who want to see him on Wednesday, 645-4543, just say that you're coming to the diabetic clinic, and that's all you need to do. And the person, 7905, I don't know why you're calling me while I'm live on the air, 720-7905, don't do that. Please don't do that. Not because you have my number, you'll call me while I'm on the air.
That's a no-no.
That's a no-no. And that's why I will call your number.
Mm-hmm.
I think some people are too disrespectful at times.
Yeah, but this is what I don't understand. You're doing, as a matter of fact, you've got the option of calling 222-8255. Or 612-8255. You know, why call in your private when you are dealing with people?
Or you can even send us a WhatsApp message or a text message. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Very easy to do that.
Yeah.
What's blinking there? Sometimes blinking to the side. Winking, blinking, and nod. Why is that? You need to check that.
I think the system is dumb.
It has to be that the system is dumb.
I don't mind it blinking, but as long as it don't move while it blink.
True.
That's another story by itself. Anyway, folks, taking our time to 20 minutes before 11 o'clock.
If people only know that story.
We'll take a break and would be right back with you. Stay tuned.
You're like,
yeah.
Why?
It don't make sense. Because you're using the messenger server. No, I'm good.
So that was just a big?
Yeah, a hullabaloo.
Welcome to Carnival 2019 on main stage Power 102, celebrating the Masters.
Celebrating the Masters.
A celebration of Trinbagonian culture. Come and enjoy the sweet enticing sound of Pan.
Your brother really enjoy himself in his square. You already know I stand up in a corner and I'm good with that. I really enjoy myself standing up on his side.
Sorry, they called me. I didn't come early.
I didn't plan on going.
Huh?
I didn't plan on going.
If you had called me, I would have.
I didn't plan on going. On
Power 102. I knew I had to be on stage. I felt this is a place.
But I stay home. Stuart came home early. And I don't like to leave my dog by herself. So as he came home, if I had to not any barring, but if I have to go out, and nobody to watch my dog, and I had to go for 2 or 3 hours. Was I not going or not?
Yes.
No, I'm not going, no.
So you need someone to watch your dog?
No,
I thought the dog was supposed to be the watchman.
No.
I thought it was a watchdog.
No, your brother is saying, I don't like to leave her by herself for a lot of hours.
But why?
Because they have the neighborhood too, you know.
Oh, yeah.
They throw something, a piece of meat. What I can tell you that we are taking sex education to a whole new level. Quality Nighttime Program is here at Power 102 FM, your number one all around station when it comes to talk and music. This is what it's all about. Taking our time to 17 minutes before 11 o'clock. Sexplosion, our lines are open, 222-8255. Also, 612-8255. Yep.
Kenry came up with a very good idea here. Since no one is calling, have a discussion about swingers. He said he's sure that people will hook up for that topic. What about swingers? You know, I had to discuss this with someone recently. I had a discussion on it, and I had to put that person to understand, make them understand that everybody wants to be part of a swingers club who are into sex and perversion and kinkiness and whatnot. And you know, I don't like to use those words, but I'm using it very loosely tonight. For the simple reason that they want the rewards of it.
Mm-hmm.
But it's never about the individuals who are part and parcel of it. And that's what makes the difference between a successful swingers club and a non-successful swingers club. There are many swingers clubs that came and went by the way.
Mm-hmm.
Because it was all about the persons who have the swingers club, about their gratification, their personal gratification, as opposed to the persons who are members of the swingers club getting their freak on.
Okay, yeah.
And that's why my swingers club RSO has been so successful for all these years, since 1986 to now.
Mm-hmm.
So successful, and it continues to be successful because it's not about me. It's always about the members and what they want and what we can do to spice things up and make things different.
I see that they have a fun time.
Right. One of the first things about being a swingers is you must have the mindset to it. You must be mentally prepared to get into the life of swinging, because swinging is not an easy thing. It's not an easy thing to see that the person that you love is having sex with somebody else.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That's not an easy thing. Everybody wants to be a swinger, but they don't think about all these things. They don't think about the ramifications of it. They don't think about what it's going to do to their relationship, if it's going to cause a breakup, if it's going to cause a strengthening of their relationship. And they don't know if it's going to do that because they have never done it before.
Mm-hmm. But from your experience in organizing swingers, gathering, have anybody ever really come to a swingers club that you experienced and after they don't come back because they broke up?
Yeah.
Of course.
It has happened many times.
Okay.
Many times in our consultation for a person to join the swingers club, I tell them this is not for you.
Okay.
And so, I know they have gone to other clubs and they break up.
So you can tell.
Because you can tell.
You can tell. Yeah.
You know, there's something called a ticket in swinging. A ticket is when you use your wife, your spouse, or your girlfriend to get into the swingers club so you could get your personal gratification, your sexual, the sexual things that you need, and not have your partner participate. That don't work in a swingers club, you know. Because for in time, those who are experienced in a swingers club know you using your partner as a ticket, you dead.
Okay.
Because the things that they're going to do there, you wouldn't like it.
Oh, okay.
Because
they're
going to get your partner involved. And they're, believe me, when you're adept at the art of swinging, you could pursue a woman or persuade a woman to do things that she will not normally do.
So have you seen from your, so then again, I'm going on your experience. Have you seen one party doing something to another person and it's something that they wouldn't have done with their partner?
Yes.
Before?
Yes. That's what, but I've seen, I remember one couple, and they know who they are, who came from South to the swingers club. The first time they came, I realized the person was using his partner as a ticket. No big deal. The directors got together and we said, okay, the next time he comes, he's going to be taught a lesson. And he was taught a serious lesson. Because his partner wanted to engage. But because of the warning or whatever threats he made or whatever for she not to do anything, she was sitting there in fright. But then she was made to feel comfortable.
Okay.
Because everybody realized what was going on. Because the women pick up on it, the men will pick up on it, because these are seasoned people in the arena.
Well, of course, yeah.
And it was all about the comfort and the making the person feel totally welcome. And the next time, she participated, he couldn't say anything about it. But he was using her as a ticket.
But as you rightfully said, you know, that is something that you really have to have a mindset to participate.
But that's the negative side of it. The positive side of it, people who are involved in the life of us, the swinging lifestyle, they know what they want. They know what they're capable of doing.
And that's what they come for.
That's what they come for. What happens there, stay there. Yes means yes, no means no, and it ends there. There's nothing other than that.
But
there's no contacting afterwards. There's no you checking me or I checking. That doesn't happen
again,
until the next get together.
Again, I have to come back to your experience as far as where the swing is concerned. Was there ever a time that someone come, his or her partner participated and they get left out?
Yeah. That happens also.
Yeah, but you'll feel like a fool.
Well, it's not a matter of feeling like a fool. It's sometimes you have performance anxiety. You're unable to perform.
Yes, but I'm speaking in terms of if you are able to perform, but you get left out.
That hardly happens because no one wants to do that to another person because they would not like that done to them. But based on performance anxiety, I've seen person pack up and pull aside.
Yeah.
And just sit down and watch because they can't do anything. They're not... They maybe they're so anxious or so excited about what's going on. They can't participate the way they want to participate, or they want to do too much. It's like the dog and the bone. They want more than one bone.
Okay.
So there are a number of factors and there are a number of things that you have to weigh. How cool am I going to be? How relaxed am I going to be? What are my limits?
Yeah, but
am I going to step over the bounds? Excuse me, what is going to affect me mentally? But you don't know unless you are in it. That's why I tell you, I have seen persons who have condemned certain things sexual in the strongest possible way. And once they're faced with that situation, they let loose and they do it. And they enjoy it 100%. They may not do it again, But at the moment, oh my God.
That particular time.
Oh my God. They are into it and they enjoy every single part of it.
Mm.
Both male and female. Mm. And if you ask them if they have done it or if they'll do it again, they'll tell you no. But at the moment, you know they participated and you know, but maybe they want to block it off or maybe they don't want to accept the fact that I did it.
Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah.
But in sex, you have to be very careful about the things that you condemn.
Mm-hmm.
And you will never know unless you're faced with the situation and either you accept or refuse.
Mm.
Okay, prior to you getting involved in something that is highly charged and highly sexual.
Okay, before you go a bit further, what I'm going to do is take a break here. And we're going to take a break. I hate to use the word short break. We're going to come right back. Stay tuned.
Tune in to Game Time this Saturday for what promises to be a fiery edition. Trinidad and Tobago Super League and current TTFA board member Keith Lucklow will be in studio. That's right. He'll address the current lack of transparency in the TTFA, home of football, the high-handed approach by the TTFA president, why after 3 years there are no subcommittees appointed, why the slow pace in sorting out financial issues, and much more. So tune in to Game Time just after the midday news on Power 102.1 FM this Saturday.
Well, folks, taking your time, it's now 10 minutes before 11 o'clock. Sexplosion on this Friday evening with the only sexologist in the Caribbean, Dr. Raj Ramanan, Total Image, and the Adult Therapy Center, which is located in St. Augustine. Our lines are open for those of you who would love to interact with him via the telephone. Feel free at 222-8255, also at 612-8255. Yeah.
Somebody asked, Dr. Raj, what is your take on prostate enlargement? Do you mean doing something to enlarge your prostate? If you're thinking about that, something is wrong with you mentally. Nobody wants to enlarge their prostate.
No, I wouldn't think so.
So we, if you have an enlarged prostate, that is a serious medical condition.
Mm-hmm.
But nobody wants to enlarge their prostate. Absolutely not. So we were talking about...
Swingers
and the mentality and the enjoyment of it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That mindset, you must have it. I've been to swingers gathering all over the world. Every different country, I could walk into any swingers club.
Mm-hmm.
It's very easy. I'm a director in a swingers club. I just have to show my credential and I could walk into any swingers club. There was a time that I used to go to swingers club every week, all over the world.
Mm-hmm.
No, I don't. It doesn't interest me. I have no... All I'm interested in is putting things together and making it happen for people.
Because you see, you've been through it, you see.
It's a mindset.
Mm-hmm.
It's a mindset. The things that I enjoy doing now, it's different from the things that I enjoy doing then. Because I'm mature, I have changed, I have developed, I have gone into a different realm. I don't condemn anybody who wants to do it yet.
Mm-hmm.
But what I'm saying is that...
You've been through the mill.
It's like putting together an orgy and people telling you to take part in it. Like, no.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have time for that. I don't want to be part of that. Been there, done that so many times, it doesn't matter.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
There are things, well, today I was telling someone about, I still love my photography and I still love videography. That's my passion. That's not going to change. I don't think that will change ever.
Mm-hmm. But I know you're...
And that's what I enjoy doing.
Yes, I know you enjoy doing something. I know you enjoy doing that.
I love directing. I love putting things together. I love... excuse me. That's what I like doing and that's my passion. But to actually get involved in things now as I used to before and whatnot, when the Archangel was around, I think that was a different story and a different life.
Oh, yeah.
As they say in Hindi, that was a different kata.
Mm-hmm.
I've moved on from that. Somebody asked a question here. Let's get to that. Hello, good night, Dr. Raj. Can a woman at the age of 60 get pregnant if she's producing eggs and releasing eggs? Yes. If she doesn't have a period and she's not releasing any eggs, she cannot get pregnant. Impossible.
Mm. But at 60, it could happen.
Anything is possible.
Mm-hmm.
With human beings, anything is possible.
Mm-hmm.
Anything is possible.
Yeah, because I was, I follow foreign news a lot. And I try to keep abreast of what's taking place. And I saw a woman who's 102 years old in India. Just had 102, hear me good. like a century in cricket.
Yeah, I know what 102 is. Oh, congratulations to Simon for the 102. Yes.
I heard he made a couple of runs.
A couple? I don't know why they keep him out of the team. He's the best, one of the best batsmen we have had.
Yeah, but you know they have something against him. You know,
look, they bring the bloke back and look what happened. Yeah. Hey, you're getting back to the 102.
Yeah, so 102 years old. And she had a baby.
Yeah, so what's impossible about that?
Her husband was 80-something.
So what's impossible about that?
No, but
once you have a period, once you have eggs, you can get pregnant?
But
if you don't have any eggs, you cannot get pregnant?
Yeah, but you know, this is something that don't happen on an ordinary basis.
It's not an ordinary thing, and it's not going to happen all the time.
Mm-hmm. But you know what it is to be 102? I mean, the odds are totally against you seeing that chance in a teenager.
No.
Well, anyhow, if it happened once, it could happen twice, right? That's the way you put it?
Again, when you deal with human beings, anything is possible. You don't say that it's not going to happen, ever.
Oh, boy, I tell
you. That's why I tell you, when you find yourself in a certain situation, I have seen person condemn certain things and end up doing it. I've seen women, their mindset has been so challenged by the things that are happening around them. They'll find themselves in a situation and say, I never knew I was capable of doing that. And then again, it depends on your partner and how it comes out. Your partner is very instrumental in the way you react to certain things. Always remember that we have the ability within ourselves to do certain things. But it's who going to draw that out of you, what the chemistry between you and your partner and your interaction with others, how do you draw that out? How do you get that out?
Okay.
So when someone thinks that something is impossible, the possibility exists that it can happen. It's just that you're not placed in the position for it to happen. Time, place. Time and place. And circumstance, time, place, and circumstance will make you do anything.
Wow.
But again, lovemaking, sex, anything related to that part of your anatomy, that part of your psyche, where there's physical and sexual and sensual pleasure, it could be easily swayed by what is happening around, by who you're with, by the things that are told to you, the things that you observe. All these are factors that can make things this way very easily. Very, very easily. But again, you have to have it within you, you know. Nobody could make you and force you to do something unless they put a gun to your head or they put a knife to your throat or they threaten you. There are some persons who have to do things with their partner, their spouse, their husband, because they have threat of violence and whatnot. But if you have it in you to do certain things, you'll do it naturally. You will do it naturally because it is part of you, but it is how that person brings it out. That's all it is. Somebody to caress that part of your ego, caress that part of your body, caress that part of your mind to bring it out, for you to express it. And nobody's forcing you to do it. So sometimes you find that a person is involved with someone other than their spouse.
Yeah.
And they're doing all these things with the person. And the spouse find out, and the spouse will say, well, you never do this with me, but you don't like to do those things. And I'm not doing it with the person because you don't do it. I do it with the person because that's what I like. And sometimes one party will tell itself, well, it's because I didn't do so and so. And because it's no, you should try to do so and so because that's what the person like. If you want to keep things going in a nice way. But if it's natural for a person to step outside of their relationship and do whatnot, do things, you can't stop that.
No, you can't.
You can't. You have to learn how to live with that, and you have to know how to deal with it. And this is where a lot of people, jealousy and anger and envy and all these things come in, and they can't deal with the fact that their partner has an independent way of thinking, and sex is not the way one party sees it, as opposed to the other party. Some persons see sex as purely physical. Some persons see sex as spiritual. Some persons see sex as for what it is, both spiritual and pleasurable. Some persons see sex only as a procreation.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
So there are many ways of you seeing sex. But again, it boils down to your partner and what are the possibilities of things happening and your capabilities. Mm-hmm. When you find the right partner, brother man, when you find that person, the things that you could do with that person and the things that that person does to your mind, it rocks your world. You know? Mm-hmm. It really rocks your world. You are taken into a different dimension, physically, mentally, emotionally, sexually, every other way that you could think about it.
That's why it's called soulmate.
Well, I don't like the concept of soulmate, mm-hmm. especially when it comes to things that are of a sexual nature, because you have many soulmates. There's no one soulmate that you come from, because if you understand the concept of the soul, mm-hmm. and the soul being part of the bigger soul, mm-hmm. for the want of a better word right now, the Atma is part of the Paramatma. I'll say it in the right way. We are all soulmates. Mm-hmm. We are all.
Okay.
All the soul come from one place. Mm-hmm. It didn't come from 10 different places. Mm-hmm. It is being able to attach itself through the chemistry to the right one. And the one that is going to make you experience the things that you need to experience. And this life is only about experiences, and that's why you come on this earth for, you know. Experiences. Mm-hmm. So those experiences are supposed to make you a better person as far as the experience, getting the experience, the observation, the feelings, and your ability to move forward and what it does to your spiritual self. Mm. With that, we have come to the end of our program. Mm. Mm-hmm. You didn't realize that?
No, I didn't realize it. Because
what?
I didn't realize it was the... At that particular time.
Well, right.
I thought we was over that already.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
I know you were trying to keep me beyond that. So, folks, we've come to the end of our program tonight. Of course, we're back on next week, Thursday.
Thursday from 7 o'clock.
From 7 to 9, and then Fridays from 9 to 12. Mm-hmm. 5 hours of sex in 2 days' time. Well, wow.
Yeah, hey, now what more can you ask of from a radio station? Don't
but,
you
of course, on a Friday, if you don't interact, if you don't send your messages, if you don't call,
we
end on at 11.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Good night.
You've been listening to Sexplosion right here on Power 102 FM with the only sexologist in the Caribbean.